Hello, ladies and gentlemen. One very interesting question was asked to me by a Westerner. He asked me that, of course, today is the most auspicious occasion of Balram Jayanti, which is the appearance day of Lord Balram himself. He is Krishna's elder brother, and today is the day when he had appeared in this world, roughly 5,000 years back. So Balramji is known as the Adi Guru, which means he is the source of all the gurus, and he is the main object of Guru Tattva. So all the gurus of this world or any universe, they are actually representatives of Balramji. And Balramji is the first expansion of Krishna. So there are two types of expansions of Krishna. So one kind of, I will not go to the Sanskrit names. One kind of expansion is where Krishna expands into identical forms, like in Dwaraka he had expanded into 16,108 forms. Because each and every wife of Krishna had a palace, and Krishna was simultaneously there with each of the wives. But there's another type of expansion where he expands in a form slightly different. Okay, so that is Balramji actually. So Balramji is a very special personality because he's God himself. He's none other than Krishna himself. But he does not act like Krishna. He acts as a servant of Krishna actually. So he's a very unique personality. He's God, but he acts as the servant of God. It's inconceivable. It's known as achintya. Achintya means that which we cannot conceive with our material senses actually. So how can somebody be God and act as a servant of God? It's beyond imagination, right? But yes, that is how he is, and he is the perfect servant, and he's the only personality who expands in every rasa, the five primary rasas, like Dasya Ras, Sakya Ras, then we have Vatsalya, then we have different rasas. There are five primary and seven secondary rasas, so total 12 rasas. So Madhurya Ras is there, and then secondary are like Vibhatsya Ras is there. So Balramji is the one who expands in all the five primary rasas to serve Krishna actually. He's the only one who does that, although he is God himself. So this once lady had asked me a question. She was from the West, and she asked me that what is going on between this Krishna and Balram? Sometimes they are opposing each other. Like for example, at the end of the Kurukshetra battle, not end exactly, but almost at the end, when Bhima hits Duryodhan on his thighs and breaks his thighs, and Krishna only instructs Bhima that go and hit in his thighs. But then we see Balramji comes and opposes. Balramji says, "Oh Krishna, what you have done is not good. How could you have allowed Bhima to do like this? What to speak of allowing? He was the one who instructed, So Balramji doesn't seem to be very happy. Some other times also he does this, all right? So for example, when Arjun and Duryodhan goes to Krishna to ask for help, then Arjun asks Krishna that I don't want anything but you. And Duryodhana foolishly, he takes the Narayani Sena of Krishna. He leaves Narayan, but he takes Narayani Sena. So, in fact, when it is said when Duryodhan went back to Hastinapur after gearing and cheering that, yes, I have got Narayani Sena. And this Arjuna is the biggest fool in the universe. He has got this useless Krishna who is not even going to lift a weapon, because Duryodhana was a skeptic. He was basically a modern, he was like a modern day idiot basically. So modern day idiots, they will ask these questions, you know, like materially calculative, but they're headless and they're totally, their behavior is like, it's very funny. Like Duryodhana calculated, oh, there's one side Krishna, but he will not lift weapon. And then there is Narayani Sena, you know, it is said in Narayani Sena, every warrior, every foot soldier was like one Maharathi. Maharathi is Maharathi means the leaders of the society. So there are different definitions of the word Maharathi. So one of the definitions is one who can fight with 60,000 foot soldiers at a time. So that is known as a Maharathi. Okay. So there are two ways of becoming a Maharathi. Either you defeat 60,000 warriors or you defeat another Maharathi, shortcut. So every warrior was like a Maharathi, you know, one Akshohini division of the Narayani Sena. So Duryodhana thought in that terms, you know, oh my God, whoever has Narayani Sena is victorious. And yes, that is true, because that army is invincible. Nobody can check the Narayani Sena, because it is the most elite of all the armies which were present in the Kurukshetra field that time. But Narayan was on another side. Krishna is Narayan himself, he is Vishnu himself. So whoever is on the other side, doesn't matter. Bhishma is there, Drona is there, Duryodhana is there, Shakuni is there, Dushasana is there, Karna is there. Just doesn't matter. Even if Narayani Sena is there, even whoever, even if Indra or anybody would be there, it would have simply just not mattered. All right. So, but Balaramji also gets this request from Duryodhana and Arjun, but he doesn't accept either one of them. He says, I will go to Tirth Yatra, okay. He went on visiting different holy places like Vidur. So, it apparently sometimes seems that Krishna and Balaram are contradicting each other sometimes, alright. But it is not like the barbaric dog fights between brothers and sisters in Kali Yuga. Okay, so we see sometimes brothers and sisters, or brothers versus sisters in Kali Yuga, they will fight like dogs and cats sometimes, because of property, or because of, you know, primarily because of property, primarily, yes, in Kali Yuga. And today is also Raksha Bandhan, by the way. So, but their disagreement is not like this. So Acharyas explain, why does Balaramji, although he is the topmost of all servants of Krishna, why does he disagree with Krishna sometimes? Mm-hmm. So the reason is because he wants to enhance the flavor of the pastime. This is what Acharyas explain, that Balaramji wants to bring out different flavors. So as the Acharyas explain, that suppose you have a glass of water, then you put some sugar, okay, it tastes really nice. But imagine you put a pinch of salt, it tastes even better, right? Because now you get both the flavors. Of course, it should be in harmony. You cannot put truckloads of salt, then you can't taste it, right? Or you cannot put, you know, truckloads of pepper, then also it won't be nice. But imagine you take a glass of water, there's pinch of salt, pinch of pepper, and a teaspoon of sugar, and maybe some lemon juice. So it tastes really amazing. So this is what Balaramji does actually. And Balaramji, also Acharyas explain, that he plays the role of an apparent opponent, okay, because sometimes in Kali Yuga there are many people who will doubt the actions of Krishna or Ram. You know, they will say, what Ram did was not correct, what Krishna did was not correct. According to me, he should have done like this. According to in my knowledge, he should have done like this. You know, blah blah blah, superimposing their own 10 gram brain on God. They will do like this because Kali Yuga is the age of headlessness. People are so headless in Kali Yuga that they think they have the right to judge the actions of people like Krishna and Ram also. So there are many who do it in Kali Yuga. So Balaramji sometimes acts as if apparently he's contradicting them, so that Krishna can actually give the reasons of why he is doing what he is doing. So, for example, when Balaramji did this to when Bhima had hit Duryodhan, then Balaramji opposed later on, and then Krishna explained that why he told him to do like this. This Duryodhan is the he's one of the crooks of the highest order. He doesn't deserve to live. What to speak of, you know, being killed just in a just way. So Krishna explained it, and then Balaramji again throws some spice. He says, I'm still not satisfied. And he goes away. So those people who are, as the Bhagavad Gita says, na, Bhagavatam says, you know, manda sumanda matayo. So sometimes foolish people think, oh, these two are also like, you know, normal brothers. They are, you know, fighting. They are disagreeing over something. But it's not like that. Don't think they are opposing each other. They are always on the same side. They do not fight like barbaric brothers and sisters of Kali Yuga. Alright? Never, never, never. The only aim and only goal, the only reason Balaramji exists is because he wants to make Krishna happy. That is his ultimate, the end of all objective. Alright? Thank you very much and see you tomorrow.